When criminals in this world appear and break the laws that they should fear and frighten all who see or hear, the cry goes up both far and near for Underdog!
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 Underdog! Speed of lightning!
Was calm, for no one knew what was going on in the laboratory of Simon Bar Sinister.
Gee, boss, I don't understand this new plot at all.
Very simple, Dad. At precisely 2 o'clock tomorrow, my army will strike and I will be the master of the city. My 3 airplanes will take off and attack from the sky. My 3 tanks will move out to attack. My 12 infantrymen will march on the city, and I shall be master of the city.
But, boss, 3 planes, 3 tanks, 12 soldiers. You can't take over a city with a little army like that.
I can, for I have a plan.
Sure, boss, sure. If his plan fails, he'll be the laughing stock of the whole city.
Cad was not the only one who was listening to Simon's plan. Ace TV reporter Sweet Polly Purebred had been listening in.
Oh, no! I must hurry to the police.
Let me see if I get this straight now. Simon Bar Sinister has 3 airplanes, 3 tanks, and 12 soldiers, and tomorrow he's planning to take over the city?
That's absolutely right.
3 planes, 3 tanks, and 12 soldiers.
There's nothing funny about it.
Simon Bar Sinister will be the laughing stock of the entire city. 3 planes, 3 tanks, 12 soldiers.
Oh, they don't know Simon Bar Sinister. If only Underdog were here.
But unfortunately, Underdog was busy halfway across the world, holding back a giant earthquake.
There's no need to fear. Underdog is here.
Meanwhile,
I still think you'll be the laughing stock of the city with that little army trying to take over tomorrow.
That's why I brought you here, Cad, at this late hour of the night. This is Main Street, the center of the city. On that lamppost are 2 very special buttons, which will make me master of the city.
Wow, boss, those buttons I gotta see.
This top button is attached to a special air raid siren. At 2 o'clock tomorrow, when my planes and tanks and soldiers move out, we shall cross Main Street and push this button.
So what?
So, as the people hear the siren and see the planes and tanks and soldiers, they shall all immediately rush to the nearest shelter, into the buildings throughout the city.
That makes sense. They rush into the buildings.
And that's where the bottom button comes in. I have wired this button to every door in every building throughout the city. Moments after the people are in the buildings, I push this button and...
Amazing, boss. You'll have all the people locked inside the buildings.
Then I shall be master of the city.
I gotta hand it to you. With those 2 buttons, your plan can't miss.
Exactly. Now let's return to the lab and wait for tomorrow.
Knowing nothing of the buttons, the police are sure Simon's army will fail. Is there no one who can stop the plan? There's plenty of excitement ahead in our next episode.
Go to Bongo Congo, meet the ruling king, good King Leonardo. How'd that king can swing. He and true blue Odie, all his subjects too. Dance the bongo congo, it's so good for you. Do the bongo congo, first you form a line. Rocking to the rhythm, makes you feel so fine. Now you form a circle, take a turn inside. You'll find bongo congo like a circus
King Leonardo and True Blue Odie Colony were making their annual inspection of the Bongo Congo Airport. Little did they know that King Leonardo was soon to be faced with a shocking surprise.
Chewing gum machines seem to be in order. Our benches still seem to be hard and uncomfortable enough. And I see we still have a sufficient supply of out-of-date newspapers and magazines. Yes, I'd say that everything... What's going on over there?
An American tourist, Your Majesty. He seems to be upset.
He does indeed. Come, True Blue Odie. Perhaps we can be of service.
Of course, sire.
I say, my good man, what seems to be the trouble?
Trouble? Trouble? I'll tell you what the trouble is. This guy... Hey, wait a minute. What's with you and those duds? You got those crazy skins on for a costume ball or something?
Costume ball? Duds? I am Leonardo Lion, king of all Bongo Congo. And these are the royal duds, skins. This is the royal attire.
Yeah? Well, maybe you can help me. This bird tells me I'm stuck in this dump overnight because my plane needs repairs. Now, what in the world is a tourist gonna do in a crummy place like Bongo Congo?
Dump? Crummy place? Why, this is the most unheard of thing I've ever heard of.
Pardon, sire, but perhaps the American tourist is unaware of the many points of interest in Bongo Congo.
Yes, perhaps you are unaware of the many points of interest in Bongo Congo.
Like what?
Like what? Like tell him, True Blue Oldie.
Of course, sire. Why, there's the...
Yes, King Leonardo and Odie Colony had suddenly realized that there were no points of interest in Bongo Congo. Back in the royal throne room, they discussed the shocking realization.
No wonder we never get any tourists. No wonder we never get any new citizens. What have we to offer? Confound it, this is terrible.
We must do something at once, sire.
Do something? What can I do? Build a leaning tower? Put in a waterfall? Build a pyramid? Ridiculous, confound it, ridiculous.
There may be other ways, sire. If we had some form of recreation that would appeal to the tourists.
Some form of recreation?
Yes, sire. Perhaps water sports.
By Jove, you've got it. Last one in the water is a Coco Loco.
As usual, King Leonardo decided to set the example for citizens to follow. First, Odie suggested skin diving.
You simply breathe through this, sire, and you can stay down for ever so long. They say there's an exciting new world down there.
With the king somewhat less than happy about skin diving, Odie Colony suggested...
Surfboarding, Your Majesty. You simply stand on this board and wait until the waves gently ride you into shore.
Well, confound it, where are the waves?
Certain now that these water sports would not attract tourists to Bongo Congo, the king felt that all was lost.
All is lost.
Do not despair, sire. You will find some other attraction.
Confound it, there's nothing in Bongo Congo to attract any member of the human race.
That's it, sire. You've said it. We'll have a race.
On water?
Why not on land? A cross-country race on bicycles built for two.
Of course, of course. And we'll offer a giant cash prize to the winners.
An unusual bicycle race is sure to attract millions of tourists. But will it also attract Biggie Rat and Itchy Brother? Will they ruin this exciting sporting event for tourists? We'll find out in our next exciting episode. Bye, bye, bicycle.
Card, son. I said, are you?
I, Apache, I am the hunter.
Okay, hunter. Here's the flow for your cartoon show.
One dark night, an unusual occurrence took place in one of our greatest cities. The clock on top of City Hall was striking 12 when suddenly it stopped and disappeared entirely. That was just the beginning. All over the country, clocks were being stolen. Big clocks, little clocks, grandfather clocks, and wristwatches. Until there wasn't a clock or a watch anywhere in the country. The results were disastrous. Planes couldn't land because they didn't know the time of arrival. Trains went right through towns because they didn't know it was time to stop. But the worst disaster of all was no school. The students could not tell it was time for school. The teachers could not tell it was time for school. The principals could not tell when to ring the bell. And so there was no school at all. Officer Flynn Flanagan knew it was time to call in the hunter.
Hello, I say hello. I am the hunter. Have nose, will hunt. I hunt any... Oh, it's you, Flanagan. What in the cotton blooming world are you calling me so early for? What time is it anyway? You don't know. Now, what kind of police are you? What? All the clocks and watches stolen. Well, by granny, that's great. I'll just go back to sleep. What? Oh, the little children aren't going to school. Well, say, that is disastrous. Imagine none of those little old kiddies learning to read. Why, all they'll know how to do is watch TV. I'll get on the case right away. Kind of a watch case. Your time is my time. Yeah, you might say I've got time on my hands. Pay attention now. Those are jokes. A real... Hello? Well, he hung up. True to his word, the hunter lost no time in getting on the case. He had hardly left his home when he came upon his first clue.
Uh-huh, my first clue. Clocks for sale here. Of all the nerve. I'll just sneak up on them. All right now, who's in there?
There's nobody here but us cuckoos.
A likely story, I'm a-coming in. Now, who's the head cuckoo here?
A little old clockmaker, me.
Well, then, where are all your clocks?
Somebody stole them. There's nothing left but cuckoos.
Well, I'll just see about that.
Cuckoo hunter, listen to the birdie.
A bit dazed from his experience in the clock shop, the hunter was continuing on the trail of the missing timepieces when he overheard a remark that made him very suspicious.
Your timing's all wrong, killer. Try it again.
Timing, killer. By grannies, I've got 'em cold now.
And the unsuspecting hunter jumped right through the window and right into the ring with Killer Kelly, who was training for a big fight.
Put up your...
Perfect, killer, right on the book. Your timing's right on, kid. Let 'em have it. Kid, you're gonna be the champion.
Then maybe I could get a better sparring partner, huh? He wasn't too good, you know what I mean?
Meanwhile, the fox who had stolen all the clocks and watches opened up a new company called Take Your Time Incorporated and was selling watches guaranteed to run slow.
I tell you, friend, these clocks run so slow you can do a full day's work in half an hour and have the rest of the day to play. Get one for every... What's your hurry, pal?
I can't stop now, son. I'm on a big case. I'm in a terrible hurry.
I got just what you need, pal. Now, here's a beauty, and I can let you have it for...
Just a minute there. That's my watch. Why, you wily, clever criminal.
Uh-oh. Oops.
Ah, sure, Hunter, and you've done it again. The fox and the clocks. Now all the little children can go back to school. Ah, how can we ever repay you?
Why, a simple testimonial dinner and a gold watch will be fine, son.
Who was that modern minute man, officer?
That, me lad, was the hunter. Ah, you can always recognize him by the sound of his horn.
England. Did I tell you about my encounter with the Black Knight?
Really, Commander, it's much too...
The King ordered me to bring in the villain, and of course that meant a deadly duel.
En garde!
Hastily, I drew my sword and closed my visor. Unfortunately, I had to reopen the visor. Forgot to remove my pipe, don't you know? The Black Knight was a tremendous swordsman. Soon, he had me up a tree. He swung a telling blow for my head, but I managed to block it. Half of my sword fell away, but bravely I fought on. Fighting with only the hilt of my sword, I was soon backed up to a precipice, a sheer drop of 1,000 feet. The Black Knight raised his deadly sword. It thundered down and sheared the mighty McBragg in two.
Sheared the... Oh, no.
Oh, no, indeed. Just as the villain lifted his sword, I escaped through a back hatch in my special armor. And when he split the armor, I was already behind him. And that's how I captured the Black Knight.
I say, Commander, that was a night to remember.
Quite.
Bongo Congo, it's so good for you. Do the Bongo Congo, first you form a line. Rocking to the rhythm makes you feel so fine. Now you form a circle, take a turn inside. You'll find Bongo Congo like a circus ride.
In our last episode, to attract tourists, King Leonardo set out to interest the people in water sports by trying them himself. He tried skin diving.
Yow!
And then he tried surfboarding. Yow! Finally, the King and Odie decided to stage a unique sporting event.
A race on bicycles built for two.
Of course! And we'll offer a giant cash prize to the winners.
Immediately, word of the race spread.
Wow, Kingsley's getting smart, offering a big cash prize in a race on bikes for two.
Yeah, cool, man. Here's one beat will have a ringside seat.
Yeah, you'll have a seat, okay? Right on one of the bicycles, see? We're winning that prize money one way or another.
News of Biggie and Itchy entering the race reached the King and Odie.
If the villains win, sire, we'll lose all our tourist trade. For no one would again enter a race first won by those two cheaters.
Then you and I will enter the race to stop them.
And so on the day of the big race, the King and Odie waited at the starting line along with Biggie and Itchy and all the other racers.
Those two traitors will never win with that bicycle. Look at the extra weight they're carrying.
But little did King Leonardo realize that this extra weight was really a concealed motor. And as the race got underway...
On your mark! Get set! Ready!
Quickly, Biggie Rat uncovered the motor and turned it on. And in seconds, Biggie and Itchy were far out in front.
Look, sire, they've taken the lead.
Oh, no! Faster, Odie, pedal faster!
And away we go!
Hold on, Itch. Pull over a minute.
Yeah, but gee, Big, why, like, break the bike?
Because I'm taking no chances, say. I'm moving that dead end sign.
I dig, Big. You put the sign on this road, and those kooks will, end up at a dead end.
Turn here, Odie.
But, sire, I think...
Turn, confound it, turn!
While the King and Odie and the other riders were disentangling themselves, Biggie and Itchy zoomed confidently on their way.
Gee, Big, this motorcycle bike is like a cool tool. Those guys will never catch. Hey, Big, our power's pooped.
Pedal, slowpoke. I'll push.
But I think we're gonna... I got you, Big, I got you!
Let go of me, you pedal punk. Take your hands off my...
I think something went wrong, Big.
I think something went wrong, Big. You numbskull. Now we'll have to use the fly plan.
The fly plan?
Right. We're taking a shortcut over Bottomless Canyon. Let's go.
And moments later, at the edge of Bottomless Canyon, Biggie put his fly plan into action.
All right, Itch. Start flapping.
Gee, Big, I'm more like a flipper than a flapper.
Flap, wait.
Okay, Big, I dig.
And as Itchy began flapping the special wings Biggie had brought, their bicycle began soaring across the canyon.
Look, sire, Biggie and Itchy are crossing the canyon.
If they do that, they'll be right at the finish line. What can we do?
Wait, sire, I have a plan.
Quickly, Odie Colony made a lasso from the rope he carried. Then, whirling the lasso, Odie sailed it through the air and lassoed the wings right out of Itchy's hands. Biggie and Itchy were finally out of the race, and only moments later, the winners crossed the finish line.
The winners, those two wacky mechanics from America, Orville and Wilbur Long.
Isn't it wonderful, sire? Two Americans won the race. Now we're certain to have millions of American tourists in Bongo Congo.
Yes, once again, the King and Odie had outwitted Biggie and Itchy. But what new schemes will they scheme to make themselves rich?
With two amazing buttons on a lamppost across Main Street, Simon Bar Sinister meant to lock up everyone in the city and then take over for himself. The hour for his attack was rapidly approaching.
Come on, Cad. We dare not be late.
Yeah, boss. We want to be right on time when we push those buttons.
What are all those silly people doing? What's all the noise?
Gee, boss, it looks like a parade.
Let me through. Get out of my way. I have to cross the street.
You can't cross the street. This is the Thanksgiving Day parade.
But I must cross the street.
Not a chance. The parade will be going on for hours.
Gee, boss, if you don't get to those buttons, your planes and tanks and soldiers will move out alone, and you'll be the laughing stock of the city.
We've got to cross Main Street.
The only way we could cross this street is to get rid of the Thanksgiving Day parade. And the only way you can do that is to get rid of Thanksgiving.
That's it. Now get rid of Thanksgiving. Hurry, we must get back to the lab.
You really going to fix it so there's no more Thanksgiving?
No more turkey. No more mashed potatoes. No more cranberry sauce.
Aha! Where can those two be running? I must follow them and see what they are up to.
How are you going to get rid of Thanksgiving?
The time bomb.
The time bomb?
With this bomb, we can go back in time. I simply set the dial to the year I want. 1621. Then wind up the bomb. Then we wait for the bomb to explode and carry us back to 1621. We shall go back and see to it that the pilgrims and Indians are not friendly. Then there shall be no Thanksgiving feast and no Thanksgiving Day parade.
Gee, no more Thanksgiving.
He's done it. Oh, if only Underdog were here. Where, oh, where has my Underdog gone? Oh, where?
Halfway across the world, suddenly Underdog, with his ultrasonic hearing, heard...
Where, oh, where has my Underdog gone?
When Polly's in trouble, I am not slow. It's hip, 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 and away I go. There's no need to fear. Underdog is here.
Oh, Underdog, thank goodness. Simon Bar Sinister has gone back in time to make the Indians fight the pilgrims. He wants to get rid of Thanksgiving forever. To get rid of the Thanksgiving Day parade. We must get inside the lab and see if there's anything we can do. Look, Underdog. The time bombs that can send people back in time.
It seems we too must go back in time to halt Bar Sinister's sinister crime.
Simon said you just set it to the date you want, 1621. Then wind it up. And when it explodes, we will be back with the Pilgrims and Indians and Simon Bar Sinister.
Does Sweet Polly Purebred have the instructions right? Will they be able to stop Simon Bar Sinister from getting rid of Thanksgiving? There's a thrilling time ahead in our next exciting episode.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do